Welcome back. Now, Parliament's portfolio committees on agriculture, rural development and land reform, as well as labour and employment, are currently investigating the living and working conditions of farm dwellers and farm workers. Now, this is as a result of a motion that was tabled by the economic freedom fighters in Parliament in November 2020, which originally called for the establishment of an ad hoc committee to thoroughly investigate the living and working conditions of those whose lives are tied to farms. Now, for us more on this and the work that has already been done, we're joined by EFF Member of Parliament Constance Mkhonto. Thanks so much for your time and welcome to Morning Live, Ms. Mkhonto.
Good morning, Sakina. Good morning to your viewers. Thanks for having me.
So let's go back to the genesis of this. Firstly, just remind us again about how this process came about.
This process, Sakina, came about when all workers from different sectors coming to the EFF, to our labor desk, and complaining about their working conditions. But when we were busy doing follow-up, we realized that with farm workers, it's a different situation. On top of them being subjected to poor working conditions, they are also subjected to poor living conditions. Hence, the motion in Parliament to say there must be an ad hoc committee that will look at the living conditions of farm workers and farm dwellers.
So in terms of the process unfolding thus far, there have been public hearings that have taken place, but where have they taken place and when will the process actually be concluded?
Remember, Sakina, we are two teams. So the two portfolio committees that you have referred to were divided into two teams. So we have already gone to six provinces. We are left with nine, and we are expected to conclude this coming weekend. One team will go to the Eastern Cape, one will go to KwaZulu-Natal, and then the last weekend of July, both teams together will go to the Western Cape. So we'll conclude the work at the end of July.
Ms. Mkhonto, in terms of the turnout for these public hearings, how has it been? Did you find that farm workers and, of course, owners in some instances have come out in their numbers? Please talk to us about what some of the key takeaways also have been so far.
Sakina, farm workers and farm dwellers have been coming out in numbers. And though they are a little bit skeptical to relate to their working and living conditions, because according to them, they are afraid that they might be victimized. Very few farmers have joined us. Other farmers couldn't even allow us to have access into their farms. Then you ask yourself, what is hidden behind those gates written private property, right of admission reserved, trespassers will be prosecuted? You ask yourself, it means there is a lot that is going on behind those walls. Now we are having a very good example of what is going on behind those walls, Sakina. We are having our own president of the country, Cyril Ramaphosa. There are allegations that there are things that are happening behind those walls to farm workers and farm dwellers.
I'm just curious to know whether the portfolio committee deems it important to actually have the farmers participate. And I fully understand that you cannot force them to join in these public hearings. But surely they have to be part of the solution going forward. So is there any specific outreach that is targeted at farm owners to get them to understand, firstly, what this particular outreach is about, and two, to participate in this with a view to finding a lasting solution?
Sakina, when it comes to living conditions, yes, our target group was the farm workers and the farm dwellers. But when it comes to working conditions, we need farm workers because, you know, in every story, there's always two sides of the story. So we want to talk to them and understand where they're coming from. Why are they subjecting these farm workers to the conditions that they do? Yes, it is difficult for farm workers and farm dwellers to express themselves freely when farmers are there. But then we always devise some means to say to them, we will take their contact numbers. They will be able to tell us some of the things that they can't relate in front of the farm owners or their employers. So that's the challenge we are having, Sakina. You can't solve these challenges without the farmers themselves. They have to be involved.
But I must say, I take your explanation, and you're absolutely right. There might be there's a definite power dynamic at play here, and you're absolutely correct that perhaps the farm dwellers, the farm workers, would not be able to fully express themselves if the owners are there. But of course, there has to be a conversation that involves the owners, and maybe at some point bring them together. But Ms. Mkhonto, are you confident, though, that this will actually yield the desired outcomes in terms of improving the lives and livelihoods of farm workers and farm dwellers?
Sakina, remember that as the EFF, when we put the motion, we said we suggested that there be an ad hoc committee that will be formed. And that ad hoc committee, our aim was that through the recommendations and the report of that ad hoc committee, ultimately that will lead to the establishment of a land ombudsman or an establishment of a people's land court. Because, Sakina, we are dealing with a very deep-rooted a challenge here, a challenge that is having a very strong historical background. You cannot solve or intervene by going to one or two farms in a province. It is not possible. We need permanent institutions and institutions that will level the ground in terms of the vulnerable farm workers and the farm dwellers accessing equal rights in front of that institution to solve their problems. What we are doing now, Sakina, is not what our motion was all about in Parliament, but the ANC used its majority to end up giving us this portfolio committee visits. But according to us, it won't help us unless those institutions we are thinking of are being established and they are permanently there, because we're looking at the ombudsman to have at least equal rights and equal powers, the same as the public protector. So we are confident that the challenges that are deep-rooted, institutionalized in the farming community will be resolved.
So what about the issue of farm evictions? This is, of course, still very troublesome in the sector. How is Parliament intending to intervene in this regard?
There are policies and acts, Sakina, when it comes to that. But farmers are using the loopholes in those. There is the extended the ESTA Act that is meant to extend a tenure for farm workers and farm dwellers. But what they are doing now, they are doing what we call constructive illegal evictions. They make the environment to be unbearable for the farm workers, and they themselves decide that, no, we can't stay here anymore, and they decide to leave the farms. So the illegal evictions are very massive, and you can see that the farmers are unionized. They are having meetings that they have discussing these things. They evict these farm workers and replace them with illegal migrant workers.
So just in terms of that, I mean, are we speaking now empirically, or are we speaking anecdotally in terms of the replacement of evicted farm workers with illegal foreign nationals? Because if we know this empirically, why is it not being dealt with legally?
Sakina, farm workers, what you must understand about farm workers and farm dwellers, they are very far from government services. They are very far from accessing the policing system, the judiciary system, even labor centers. They are isolated. So for them to go and report what they are experiencing in the farms is very difficult. There is no transport in many cases for them to go to such services. And when they get a chance of going, they are given what we call leave without pay. That sector, Sakina, makes the workers to be very, very vulnerable. They are vulnerable. They can't help themselves unless, as Parliament, we establish institutions that will be able to intervene. The illegal migrant workers themselves, they are able, some of them, to talk to us and tell us that how are they exploited in those farms. They are treated like animals. They are subjected to very poor working and living conditions, because the only aim, the sole aim of employing illegal migrant workers, Sakina, is just to exploit them. They are not paid according to the prescripts of the national minimum wage. They are not, they don't contribute in UIF. They are not paid any compensation fund when it is due to them. There are many things that are going on there. It is the illegal migrant workers themselves that are coming to the committee to say, this is what we are experiencing. And in this farm, for example, one farm in Gauteng, with 350 workers, only 39 are South Africans currently.
So, and the problem there, quite apart from just the exploitation and everything that's going on, Ms. Mkhonto, is you have a problem of illegal migrants working on these farms. You are speaking to them. Then, you know, it's almost as if the problem just gets exacerbated. You start chasing your tail, because one problem gives rise to another problem and so on and so forth. Because why is the question of the illegal workers also not being dealt with? Okay. We seem to have lost Ms. Mkhonto there, unfortunately. But hopefully we'll be able to pick up because those public hearings continue, and we'll find out from Ms. Mkhonto where exactly and when the next round of hearings will take place. If she is there, if I can maybe just ask that final question to Ms. Mkhonto with regard to this matter. Ms. Mkhonto, you're back. Thanks so much. So I was asking about dealing with the question of illegal farm workers. Firstly, if we know they are there, why is that situation not being dealt with? Because we seem to be exacerbating problems all by ourselves as well. If someone is working illegally, that is something that needs to be dealt with lawfully, legally. Why are we not dealing with it? And also, where is the next round of hearings going to take place?
When we do these visits, Sakina, specifically when there are allegations from the labor inspectors of illegal migrant workers, we are accompanied by the Department of Home Affairs, the police, Department of Labor inspectors, and the officials from the Department of Agriculture. I think from now, we will be able, as a joint effort, we'll be able to solve such problems. Because the challenge that we had, Sakina, is that the department, the labor inspectors were working in silos. The Department of Home Affairs working in silos. The Department of Agriculture working in silos. So now, we are going to recommend that they work together for them to be able to solve these problems. The next visit, Sakina, this coming weekend, the weekend that starts from the 14th, I think it's a Friday, one team of the Joint Portfolio Committee is going to KZN, and the other team is going to the Eastern Cape. And then together, both teams will be visiting the Western Cape during the last weekend of July.
Well, Ms. Mkhonto, thanks so much for your time. EFF Member of Parliament Constance Mkhonto there speaking to us about the hearings that are currently underway. And as she says, this coming weekend will be the next round, looking at the living conditions of farm dwellers and farm workers. And obviously, Parliament doing this with a view to improving the lives and livelihoods of those people. We're going to take a, well, we're not taking a break. It's 8 o'clock. It's time for news.